A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 14th Feb, on the front page you have published criminal history of candidates, Supreme Court orders parties. So this is a Supreme Court judgment which it says is applicable to organizations both at central and state level. So alarming increase in incidence of criminals in politics. So there are many criminals entering into politics is evident. You can see there are many MPs. Percentage of MPs with pending criminal cases has significantly increased if you look at the data. So for 2019, it was 43% of the MPs have pending criminal cases. The 2018 constitutional bench judgment, you know, that formed the basis for the verdict which Supreme Court has given now also said that rapid criminalization of politics cannot be arrested by merely disqualifying tainted legislators, but should begin by cleansing political parties. If political parties do not have such tainted people standing for elections, they would not become legislators. So that's what the Supreme Court has stated earlier, that they should not be allowed, they should not be made to contest elections only. And that is in the hands of political parties. Whom do they give the ticket? Then this is cloud over trade talks as US official puts off trip. So US trade representative, he has put off his trip to India this week. At least two official sources have said that, you know, the India-US trade talks have hit a rough patch now before President Donald Trump's visit. So we have discussed about the issues which are there between India and USA with respect to trade. It is basically high tariffs which India imposes, and the present budget also how it has imposed high tariffs on medical devices. A health cess has been announced in the budget. So already US was having problem with tariffs, and now extra tariffs have also been imposed. So that is it. Then this is coronavirus death spike in China. So now record 242 people died in one day in Hubei in China because of coronavirus. Japan also has recorded its first death due to coronavirus. Then this is slapping section 144 during CAA protests illegal. So this is what Karnataka High Court has declared, that it is illegal, the order, you know, which has been passed by the Bengaluru City Police Commissioner imposing section 144 of CRPC from December 19, 2019 ahead of the series of pro and anti CA rallies. So this is illegal. Also here you can see did not the decision making process as such, that it was said that the order was passed by district magistrate and it had only examined the decision making process, means how the decision was made. By invoking section 144, the court said we did not examine the correctness of the decision, but the process of decision making was not legally followed. Then this is 11,000 trees to be cut for Jewar Airport. So this is in Rajasthan. So Apex Committee of the Union Environment Ministry has cleared the cutting of 11,182 trees for the proposed Jewar Airport. This is in UP, Jewar Airport in Gautam Buddha Nagar in Uttar Pradesh. And this is experts meet to discuss restoration of Sun Temple. So this is a Sun Temple in Konark in Odisha. So steps have been taken to restore it. You can see archaeologists, engineers will review the safety of the 800-year-old structure in Konark. On page 2 you have NGT calls for coercive steps against ministry officials. So this is National Green Tribunal, which has directed the Ministry of Defence to provide names of the officials concerned who have to have who will have coercive measures taken against them. So this is because National Green Tribunal had actually asked for scientific disposal of waste generated by weapons, hospitals, and other establishments of the armed forces. So the Joint Secretary of Ministry of Defence was summoned to appear before the bench and furnish a report. But order was duly conveyed, it is said, by email, but no response had been received, nor had the Joint Secretary concerned cared to appear. So this is in the case of in view of repeated failures. Now coercive measures have become necessary against the concerned joint secretary, including attachment of salary and issuance of warrant. On page 7, you have 10 years on, German bakery blast continues to haunt relatives of victims. So this is regarding German bakery blast, which took place in Pune. It claimed 17 lives and left over 50 people injured. So it's been 10 years to this incident. Some survivors want the government to take steps to rehabilitate those who suffered physical disabilities after the blast. And others feel the victims have not got justice, as some perpetrators of crime are yet to be arrested. Foreign nationals from Italy, Sudan, Nepal and Iran were also those who were killed and injured in this incident. So ATS investigated into the blast. It arrested even Indian Mujahideen operative Yasin Bhatkal, who is currently in Tihar jail. Then below you have future training of marine engineers must be tailored to evolving technologies. So this is President Ramnath Kovind, who reviewed ceremonial parade at INS Shivaji in Lonavala. So this is the country's premier naval training institute. On page 8, you have Travancore royal family upset with Attorney General's submission in Supreme Court. So the royal family says that we never staked claim to the valuables in Shri Padmanabha Swami temple. So presently it is Sabrimala temple whose valuables are proposed to be, you know, audited as such. An inventory will be listed out as such. But in the same case, the reference was made to Padmanabha Swami temple, and in this it was said the royal family staked claim, but then finally the government it was finally concluded by the courts that it is the government which will have access and will have right over the, or even will have the authority to look into the valuables of Sabrimala, of Padmanabha Swami temple. So here, Shri Padmanabha Swami temple case, Travancore royal family says that we never staked claim to the valuables. So this clarification has been given by them. And this is time running out to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. So this is a report titled Future of Earth 2020. So it lists key global risks. So here you can see the report has been released by K. Kasturi Rangan, former chairman of Indian Space Research Organization. And it is a report which has been released by South Asia Future Earth Regional Office of Divecha Center of Climate Change of Indian Institute of Science. So it lists down various risks because of climate change, and also it has looked into what will be the consequences of this too, of climate change. So this is. Then this is IPS officer moves CAT against suspension. So you should know about CAT, Central Administrative Tribunal. So this is the tribunal where government officials can take their cases. So he seeks release of salary and other benefits. So you should know about this. Then this is going energy neutral. 13 South Central Railway stations tap the sun. So solar photovoltaic panels have been installed on rooftops, which are integrated with solar plants. So now energy neutral means getting energy neutral means you're consuming electricity, but you're also producing more of renewable electricity, taking balancing those consumptions of conventional energy. So it becomes energy neutral. So this is proposed. On page 9, you have government notifies medical devices as drugs. So Union Health Minister has notified medical devices used on humans as drugs under Drugs and Cosmetics Act with effect from 1st April 2020. And the government also released the Medical Devices Amendment Rules 2020 for mandatory registration of such devices. So the notification will make companies accountable for quality of the devices as such. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Managing Perceptions. So this article talks about the visits which have taken to been taken to Jammu and Kashmir, a group of envoys. Now, a third group of envoys actually went to Jammu and Kashmir, a second officially. So, this editorial says, what should worry India is the ground reality in Kashmir, not the views of other countries. This is editorial on that. And this is terror and punishment. So, this is regarding Pakistan. It says, Pakistan must give up its strategy of using terrorism for geopolitical leverage. So, yesterday it was in news on the front page that how Hafiz Saeed has been arrested by the order has been passed by the anti-terrorism court. But then it is also ahead of the Financial Action Task Force meeting in Paris, in which it would be decided whether Pakistan should be removed from the grey list or not for money laundering and terror financing charges. So Pakistan is just taking these steps as cosmetic steps to make sure that it comes out of the grey list. So this is speculated. Even the action against Hafiz Saeed for the first time now is said to be part of strategy to convince Financial Action Task Force, the intergovernmental body fighting money laundering and terror financing. The lead article is Towards a New World Order. So this talks about how effective safety nets, free education and healthcare, and high taxes on the rich need to form part of the system. So the World Economic Forum meet also held at Davos in Jan 2020. So it was known for all forms of capitalism. So this World Economic Forum started in 1971 with the noble object of improving the state of the world. But now it is a platform of world leaders, billionaires, professionals at the top of the business pyramid. We should talk about capitalist initiatives. But this article talks of how these social measures could help, and even along with high taxes for the rich could help, a new world order where our problems can be majorly resolved. And this is heralding a politics of change. So this is regarding Delhi verdict. So it is resistance to BJP's divisive, hate-filled approach. Then on Fridays on the op-ed page, you have a parlay coverage. Views, counter-views are given on a particular issue. So this is, should women be given command posts in the army? So it's said, like men, women should be judged on the basis of their professionalism and merit. So they should be given and allowed to hold command posts in the army. Of course, they would be appointed based on merit. And this is a marriage story for everyone. So this is Kerala High Court, which is said has the opportunity to make the concept of marriage less exclusionary. So the Special Marriage Act of 1954 allows and facilitates registration of inter-religious marriages. So it talks about this. On page 13, you have walls rise ahead of Trump trip. So this is a wall being constructed here. You can see Ahmedabad Municipal Commissioner, however, denies that it is a part of plan to hide slums. And this is many loose ends hamper probe into Pulwama attack case. So Pulwama attack, which took place a year ago, which killed 40 CRPF personnel, is being investigated by NIA, National Investigation Agency, but it is said they are unable even to trace source of explosives. On international page, you have this coverage on spread of new coronavirus. You can see countries infected. And here you have Rishi Sunak appointed Britain's finance minister. So British Prime Minister Boris Johnson has appointed Rishi Sunak as his new finance minister. So he's of Indian origin. You can see he's a three-time MP. And he succeeds Sajid Javid. On business page, you have US trade representative takes India off developing country list. So US government has changed an administrative rule, making it easier for it to impose countervailing duties on goods from India and certain other countries. So it has amended its list of developing least developed countries eligible for preferential treatment with respect to countervailing duty investigation. So it has removed India from the developing country list. And this is S&P, that is Standards and Poor, its credit rating agency, global rating agency. It has retained India's rating with a stable outlook. So its India's sovereign rating is BBB minus, so it remains so. And this is soon a panel to address fiscal policy issues. So this is a panel which will be set up by the 15th Finance Commission, and it will present consolidated fiscal debt roadmap. So steps have been taken to ensure that fiscal concerns are dealt with too. So that is right. It's fiscal deficit basically is the total borrowing requirements of the government. So we need to have a limit, a target to it, that what percentage of borrowing can be done. So that is will be looked into. So fiscal policy issues will be dealt with by a panel set up by 15th Finance Commission. So earlier also we have FRBM committees established and provided with FRBM fiscal responsibility and budget management norms. So now they would be revised. And this is SEBI devices system to track client securities. So SEBI has developed an in-house system to track the movement of client securities that are collected as collateral by brokers. So this aims to detect misuse of collateral. Collateral is something which you on basis of which you take a loan or you take an initiative. So that collateral as such would be tracked. The movement of client securities that are collected as collateral by brokers would be tracked. So that is it. Thank you. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.